Hey everyone, today we will talk about the Remarkable and the latest upgrades of the Remarkable and why you shouldn't buy it, and bear with me why I will still keep it. Stay tuned. If you follow this channel for a while, then you know that I made a comprehensive video where I compared the iPad versus the Remarkable, especially compared to using the free application on iPad, Apple Notes, versus the capabilities that we have on Remarkable. And when it comes to functionality, we have so much more on the iPad. And when it comes to price, Remarkable made it just worse because they just launched a subscription service which costs $8 a month. I actually had all the hopes into this subscription service. I don't mind paying $8 a month if I really get a service, you know. We will talk about this a bit later in the video, but first let's start with the few but very strong reasons to get a Remarkable in the first place. So after I created the video last time, I actually sent back the Remarkable and got a refund. They have a very generous refund policy, so this is good. There was no issue, but I always had the feeling I'm missing something. And it was really the feeling of writing on the Remarkable. You don't get anything like this on the iPad, even if you use the paper-like screen protector on iPad and the Apple Pencil. The feeling of writing is just a lot better on the Remarkable. The other thing is why I thought I want to get it again is this distraction-free in-your-face feeling that you get on your Remarkable. So when you look here, this is all we have, you know, it's like a sheet of paper. That's all. You know, I can touch it, nothing happens. I can keep writing. So it really feels like paper. Then I can open up the toolbar and there already the first issues come. If I want to have a distraction-free feeling, I would expect that I can access the different tools in a much better way, which is the pen, the eraser, and the selection tool. Because now, whenever I need to change something, I need to go up there, open the sidebar, go to the eraser, delete it. If you bought the more expensive pencil, you actually can just flip it around and you can delete it this way. All right, but they're charging extra for this feature. Then I have to switch back to my pencil, I can writing, and then I go here in order to select something. And then I can move it around, all right? So this is working, but it's not that distraction free. I can keep up the toolbar, but if I want to use the full piece of paper, I might draw on the side here as well. And then when I open this up, I have no access to this anymore. That's already a downside. And I think they wanted to keep it as minimalistic as possible. But if they just made three little buttons there where I can with my thumb change between the tools, this would be so much more convenient to switching tools this way. Or of course they could add it here, but this is not battery run. So it's a passive pencil that you use here. But buttons directly on the tool, it would be much more helpful. Well, it's minimalistic. You have one button on top where you can switch it off and on. So it's now sleeping. And when you switch it on, you're back on the page. And there we are. This is the in-your-face feeling. And I think this is great. I showed this in a previous video. You can access your notes very quickly on the iPad as well, but it is still a screen. And here it doesn't feel like a screen. It really feels like a physical paper that I have laying around where I made some notes. And this is already the point. If you're a paperless movement member, then I know that I teach the iCore framework. iCore stands for Input, Control, Output, Refine. Actually, if you're on the channel and you ever wondered what these symbols are that we have here, they stand for Input, Control, Output, Refine. It's the iCore symbols that you see here, just if you wondered. And in the input part, we talk about the information that we actually collect on a daily basis. Once you realize that different types of information that you're collecting, like temporary notes, business-specific notes, journaling notes, and all this, you will realize that you might need different systems to place them in. Then we come to the control part. This is actually knowledge management. How can you access the information that you collected? Do you actually just create noise by creating more notes that you never look up anyway? Or is it really an interconnected knowledge base that you created there? And this is already the limitation of Remarkable. We can just write down. There's not even a global search that I can search my notes in there. When you use an iPad, you have good Notes, Notability, NoteShelf, and Apple Notes, you can search your handwriting globally through all your notebooks. Here, this is not possible. So this is a big downside already that makes taking notes really like using a paper notebook. even worse because you cannot place any post-its and organize it this way. And there are no colors where you can highlight stuff. So this is a real downside. So this is organization-wise. And when I made the previous video, I mentioned that we cannot access the notes from all the other devices. This is again a downside that we had there. In the meantime, and this was the reason why I bought it again in order to check this out as well, they added a cloud access capability. So you see here on the side now that we have Google Drive integration. They also have Dropbox and OneDrive integration now. On the page, they even state that they sync with these clouds. Well, it's not syncing. All you can do is upload it easily to these cloud services and download it. So whenever I want to have anything from my cloud on Google, I have to press and hold. So you see already it says to open this document, please copy it to my files. And I press copy and now it downloads this and then you have a separate file. I mean, that's the worst you can do when it comes to knowledge management, that you duplicated your notebook. You would select this and you upload it to Google Drive. So now I have it here, and in order to edit this again, I need to copy it to my files again. Go to my files, and now you see it copied the same thing that I already have next to it. So now I have the same file copied back to my Remarkable. I tried to delete this, and it's not working. Why? Because it's now a PDF file. It converted it into a PDF file and it's no longer editable. So this also means I can no longer change the background. So it will stay on the dotted things. It's a PDF file now. It's no longer the Remarkable file. This is horrible. So let's keep this, select and upload. As I said, if I upload again, let's see what happened in Google Drive. It just made another copy, so there's no synchronization at all. It doesn't even replace the original note. I think this is the worst solution that you can provide to your customers, where you say, now we have the long-awaited Google and cloud integration that you all have been waiting for. Well, this is not what anybody was waiting for, I would expect. This is really just if you finish the notebook and you say, I will never use this again, I will never edit anything in there again, then you upload it to Google Drive and that's it, it will stay there. This is just, there's no point getting in Remarkable and fall into their marketing that they have there, that this is now a nice new feature. And now we really come to the worst here. I mentioned already the subscription service in the beginning. And in order to get this really bad cloud integration to connect to your Google Drive and Dropbox, you already need to pay the $8 per month. The other thing is handwriting conversion is no longer available. If you buy for a very high price the Remarkable, you need to pay for the subscription service. I made another video when it came to a notability, what I think about subscription services, that it's actually a good thing to support a company to stay alive. But in this case, it was a SaaS company which just lives from their software. Here, they are already charging for the tablet. And then they charge an additional subscription fee to run basic functionalities that any tablet will give you for free. When you buy an iPad, you will have access to all your cloud services. You will have handwriting note-taking apps that you can use to synchronize with any cloud service that you like. You will have no subscription fees in order to use the Apple Notes application that comes with the iPad. So what's the point getting a Remarkable, guys? So Tom, why did you buy it a second time? As I mentioned, I really like the feeling and all this. And they had a special offer where I got the Remarkable for $3.99 instead of for, I think it was $5.99 before that. I might be wrong here, but it was a lot more expensive. But with the launch of this new subscription service, they made it cheaper. So I got this because I thought, well, I can cancel the subscription service anytime. But now I realize that all the features, like all your notes in one place, the synchronization service essentially. Cloud storage means their Remarkable cloud storage, right? The Google Drive and Dropbox integration, handwriting conversion, screen sharing, which is a new feature as well, that you can share your screen now. And then they say something like more powerful features. What is more powerful features? It doesn't tell you anything. And then we have a Connect Lite plan, which costs just $4.99 per month and just provides you all your notes in one place, unlimited cloud storage. Come on, these file sizes are very small. We are not talking about gigabytes of file sizes. We are talking about megabytes of file sizes, because this is black and white handwriting sheets that you have there. Even if you have thousands of pages, it will never cost them a lot to store this for you on their servers, to run the servers and so on. $4.99 just provide you the synchronization between the different devices. This is a ripoff, guys. This is a ripoff. And if you have no plan at all and you just buy the Remarkable itself, what you essentially get is a piece of paper. This is it. You will store your notes on here. They say on their website, you don't need a subscription plan to enjoy better thinking with Remarkable paper tablet. For customers who don't want a monthly plan right now or cancel their subscription, our no plan option gives you access to basic note-taking features. So you can still keep your notes organized as we didn't even touch the organizing part. Write with different tools and templates, annotate PDFs, sketch and read without any distraction. You cannot even read all the ebooks that you want to read on there. You'll also be able to download our apps, import files, and use our Read on Remarkable feature. Without a subscription, you can still use the cloud to store and sync your notes. However, files will stop syncing to mobile and desktop apps if they haven't been opened in the last 50 days. They'll still be automatically stored on your paper tablet. They made this change and the launch of this subscription plan to people who bought a physical device where they depend on these services. Guys, if you start comparing again Notability with the launch of their subscription plan, this is no comparison. Here, people bought this for more than $500 and now they are stuck into the physical device. They cannot get proper these things to another device and they have to pay this if they want to use unlimited cloud storage or if they want to back up their stuff and so on. So I have to get a subscription service in order to get my notes to a different cloud. This is unbelievable. You know, when you go to their Twitter account, you see a lot of generic answers there. So I reached out to them on Twitter, asked, what is this that you say you sync with the cloud services, but it doesn't actually sync? What I get is, thank you very much for your feedback and please go to this page to hand in blah, blah, blah. So there's no public face behind Remarkable and I don't like this if there's no, it doesn't feel like real humans behind this. And this is another big difference to Apple. When I have an issue with my Apple device, I can, even if I don't have any warranty plans or anything, I always can contact Apple and they will help me as good as possible with the devices. And I'm not stuck in the Apple ecosystem, although a lot of people complain about this, there's always a way to connect Microsoft Windows and all this to your iPads. And if you're interested to how to do this, make sure to subscribe to this channel or join the Paperless Movement membership. We discuss a lot about this. But Remarkable really forces you into their ecosystem. There's no way that you can leverage this device in a different way, especially when it comes to knowledge management. And then it really worries me when I go to social media and I see people asking, where can I make bulk orders for my companies? You can let me know in the comments below if you're one of the companies buying thousands of Remarkables for your employees. I would say this will kill your productivity 100%. If you follow me and you know that I talk about single source of truth, everybody looks at the same context and in meetings, you open up the single source of truth, the tools, the software that you defined, so you have as less friction as possible when it comes to collecting and leveraging information, then using something like Remarkable will just destroy everything. This is it. If you want to make brainstorm, just imagine how much paper you could buy and pens for people to do the same stuff that you can do on Remarkable. There's no cloud sharing, there's no team folder or anything like this. So I don't get the point why companies would buy this. If you're using iPad and you use the native free application Apple Notes, you can be in one note together interacting in there. And we talk about a native application. There are so many other applications out there that I'm talking about on this channel as well, that you can use in collaboration with your team that will just level up your productivity compared to this, which is just a step backwards and of no use at all. You know, just a global search. You cannot search your notes. What's the point? When I tell people that you can switch from a paper notebook to iPad, you can still use your handwriting and the methods and all that you were used on paper notebooks, but with the advantage that the information will be stored on the cloud. At the same time, you have global search where you can search your handwriting. This is where people convert to going paperless and see the advantages there. Remarkable? Sorry, just because it feels so good like paper, I give it to my children. My children are using this now. Tom, you're crazy. You paid a lot for the Remarkable and your children are using it for drawing. Yes, I will keep the Remarkable because I want to stay up to date. I will keep it to make some simple notes like on piece of paper, but I would never buy it personally. You can guess it. They didn't sponsor me to make this video. I'm a non-sponsored channel and this is thanks to you, the Paperless Movement members. You just support me the way that I can stay unbiased and make these unbiased videos. And I really just want to tell you that you might not do any favor if you give this to a birthday or as a Christmas gift or anything like this, especially for the price you really get. I mean, just get an iPad mini. It's a smaller screen, but you get an Apple Pencil 2 with it. You put a paper-like on it. You already get very close to the feeling. Yeah, that's my opinion. I know that there are many Remarkable users out there who love this device. I really would like to know, what do you think about this change in the subscription model? What do you think about the journey that Remarkable is going on? Okay, I will stop ranting now. I will keep you guys updated if there are any changes coming to the subscription model or if my mind changes over time for Remarkable. If you want to stay up to date, make sure that you subscribe to this channel so you don't miss it. Or if you like to inform your friends what the Remarkable is really about, share it with your friends and I'll catch you up next time.